small local business since 2007, we are delighted to present you to Salt Spring's finest natural spring water. From an elevation of 830 feet and bordering on Mount Maxwell Provincial Park, our deep groundwater spring provides a steady supply of high-quality natural spring water, which we bottle right at the source. Ronan Heitzman and business partner Fitz Lee are proud to be able to provide a quality product at competitive prices along with personalized service, with home and business deliveries free of charge. For more information, we invite you to call Ronan at 250-653-4729 or go to the website at www.saltspringwaterco.com.
And we're back. This is Green FM CFSI FM 107.9
and 102.1
on Salt Spring Island, and you can reach us also on the internet at
greenfm.ca.
We're such a team.
We're bright.
And we got Banana Joe on the line. Hey Joe, how are you?
Hey Joe.
How's it going, ladies? Hello, everybody out there in Radio Land. And it looks like a beautiful start to day, or a nice sunrise coming up here in Ganges.
Yeah, yeah, it is. The sky had some nice color this morning.
And the forecast is looking pretty good, too. Still kind of dry here for our island. Normals for this time of the year should be 16 Celsius for a high, 7 for a low. Today we're going to hit 18, maybe a little bit better. If you're away from the water, and a mix of sun and clouds. Saturday, mainly cloudy. Clearing near noon, high of 18. Sunday, cloudy with a 30% chance of showers, 11 Celsius for a low, 17 for a high. And Monday, a mix of sun and cloud, lows of 13 Celsius, highs of 18. And Tuesday, sunny, lows of 10 degrees Celsius, highs of 19. Wednesday, sunny, lows of 7, highs of 17. And Thursday, sunny, lows way down to 5 degrees Celsius. And highs near 17 degrees Celsius. And a little weather fact, and this is why we appreciate living on Salt Spring Island, Canada's Banana Belt. October 3rd, 1999, southern Manitoba, Gimli and Dauphin recorded low temperatures of minus 8.4 degrees Celsius and minus 8.6 degrees Celsius. That's a little too nippy for me wearing shorts like I am right now.
And you are living up to your reputation in shorts. Thank you.
I don't think my palm trees would be too happy with temperatures like that.
No.
So I'm very fortunate to live in this beautiful place.
Okay, so Joe, if you have a minute or less, tell us how you got the name Banana Joe. Who tagged that for you?
Well, more than two decades ago, I actually introduced a species of banana that grows outdoors on this island. So it would have been in the late 90s, I guess, probably around 1998. We had a really good dumping of snow in December, December 96. And there was a little blurb in the paper by one of the weather observers at the time, Robert Aston, which is, he's passed away since, he was in his 90s. And he said, I wonder how Banana Joe is making out how are his bananas making out in the snowfall? And then it just kind of stuck.
I love it. And it's so appropriate. It just fits
it's
you.
It's all
to
appropriate.
A
I mean, I could be called worse names, but I think Banana Joe's okay.
Yeah, and everybody knows who you are, Joe. Even if they don't know you personally, everybody knows who you are.
Everybody's a familiar face on this rock.
That's right.
There you go.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right, ladies. Well, you know what? Enjoy the day and have a great weekend.
Yes, you too. Yeah,
all
for
right.
sure.
Thanks for the
it's
weather.
It's going to be good for the market.
Yes, great.
All right.
Thanks, Joe.
Bye.
All right.
Bye.
Bye now.
And Banana Joe giving us the lowdown. Thank you, Joe. As always, it's always a pleasure.
Yeah, and it sounds like it's going to be a good day for a good weekend, so that's good.
Yeah.
Get out and do something, get active, and walk around.
Yeah.
And whatever you can do, go canoeing.
Canoeing? Are you going to go canoeing?
I might.
Oh, where are you going to canoe?
I don't know.
One of the lakes, I would imagine. Hey,
or Long Harbor.